Father, we ask your blessing on the reading of your word. May your Holy Spirit lead us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Acts 15. They have discussed, and Peter rose up and told them there's no difference between them and the Gentiles, and we don't want to lay a burden on them that neither us or our fathers could bear. So verse 12, then all the multitudes kept silent and gave audience to Barnabas and Paul, declaring what miracles and wonders God had wrought among the Gentiles by them. Verse 13, and after they had held their peace, James answered, saying, Men and brethren, hearken unto me. Simon hath declared how God at the first did visit the Gentiles, and to take them a people for his name. Now remember, Simon is called Peter. We know several people God renamed. Jacob, he renamed Israel. Abram, he renamed to Abraham. Simon, he renamed Peter. Now, a lot of people have stated, but in Acts, it doesn't say that he renamed Saul to Paul. In Acts, it just says Saul also called Paul. So it wasn't something that God in Scripture renamed Saul to Paul. It just says he was also called that. So whether that be a nickname or there's some reason, the Bible is unclear. So I just remain silent on the reason why Saul is also called Paul. All right. And Simon hath declared how God at first did visit the Gentiles to take out of them a people for his name. Let's remember, we're supposed to be called out for God. So if you're a believer, you've been called out as a called out one to witness for him, but it's a people for his name. In this, as we've been talking some of legalism and in essence, maybe liberty, and some take that for license. Romans 6, it says, should we continue in sin? God forbid. So we don't want to use grace as a license to sin. And I would say when people do that, in all likelihood, they're not saved. They haven't come to an understanding of what Christ did when he died on the cross for them. So we don't want to use grace as an occasion to sin. Verse 15, and to this agree the words of the prophets, as it is written. So all the words of the prophet agree to this. Now, verse 16, after this, now after what? I believe here, this is a reference similar to what we find in Revelation. After this, in Revelation 19, when Christ is going to return and he's going to set up his millennial kingdom. So we talked about that when we went through Matthew. Christ presented as the king. He offered them the millennial kingdom, but after this, he's going to return. And I will build again the tabernacle of David, which has fallen down, and I will build again the ruins thereof, and I will set it up. Now, we as Christians should not be about rebuilding a temple. There are people who are confused, and the next temple that is going to be built, it will not be the temple of Jesus Christ. It will be the Antichrist temple in the time of the tribulation, and they'll rebuild that. And I believe they will rebuild it without the outer court. They'll build it right next to the mosque that is in Jerusalem, and they'll keep the Gentile court out of that. It won't be rebuilt to the specifications, and Jesus is going to rebuild it back to those specifications. That mosque won't be there when Jesus does it. And I think that'll be part of the covenant with the many for that 7-year period, the covenant with the many for a week. All those things spoken of in Daniel and Revelation, we're not getting into those now. But here, verse 16, when he returns, it's speaking of his return to rule and reign for his 1,000-year reign. That the residue of men might seek after the Lord, and all the Gentiles upon whom my name is called, saith the Lord, who doeth all these things. Now, right now, there's a time of the Gentiles, and we're waiting till the fullness of the Gentiles that Scripture talks about when we come in that church age. Most of the church right now are Gentiles. They're not the Jews. The Jews, there's still always a remnant in every age. There's a remnant of people that believe, I think, from all types of groups in the Lord. And dispensations, as I've talked about, dispensational theology is many times also referred to as remnant theology. And there's always a remnant of God's people in all those things, a remnant in different types of churches and things like that. But let's continue with verse 18. Know unto God all are all his works from the beginning of the world. Wherefore, now wait, backing up. All his works from the beginning of the world. The plan of God from the beginning of the world was Jesus Christ. He knew in all the dispensations that I mentioned on Monday, every single dispensation, from the dispensation of innocence until even when the dispensation of the millennium happens. The millennium will be a time of peace. They'll beat the swords into plowshares. There won't be war. Right now, people who say the millennium is now, we've had war ever since time began. We haven't had a time of world peace. Jesus will bring that in the millennial reign. It's prophesied that he will bring that. And we have not had that. We do not have that now. There's still wars going on right now, currently. But his plan in every dispensation, what we see is man fails. Man failed in the Garden of Eden, ate of the tree of the knowledge of the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil of that tree. In this dispensation, man is failing. God always succeeds where man fails. And it always points to Jesus Christ. And his plan was the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world, who is Jesus Christ, from the time he created. He knew that man would fail and he'd need to step in and be the one that succeeds. It's just putting our faith in him and what he did. And that's what we need to do. We have to have faith in nothing else. So don't beat yourself up if you failed since you've been a Christian. Welcome to the club. But you don't want to continue in those things. What are you doing so that you do grow, so that you are working on your sanctification, so your light can shine to others? And that's what we want to do. We want to let our light shine to others because we're people. He's taking out of them a people for his name. It's for his name. We don't want to cause people to blaspheme God's name because we're a believer. We want to live a life that's different and shines before men. Verse 19, wherefore my sentence is that we trouble them not, which from among the Gentiles are turned to God, but that we write unto them that they abstain from pollutions of idols and from fornication and from things strangled and from blood. Okay, so there are some things we definitely should be avoiding is what they're saying. For Moses of old time hath in every city them that preach him, being read in the synagogues every Sabbath day. Then pleased it the apostles and the elders and the whole church to send chosen men of their own company to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas, namely Judas, surnamed Barsabbas, and Silas, chief men among the brethren. They wrote letters by them after this manner, the apostles and the elders and the brethren send greeting unto the brethren, which are the Gentiles in Antioch and Syrians, Cilicia. For as much as we have heard that certain which went out from us have troubled you with words, subverting your soul, saying, ye must be circumcised and keep the law, to whom we gave no such commandment. So they really make it clear here. It's not about keeping the law of Moses, the Mosaic system. It's not about having to get circumcised. Verse 25, it seemed good unto us, being assembled with one accord, to send chosen men unto you with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, men that have hazarded their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We have sent, therefore, Judas and Silas, who shall also tell you the same things by mouth. For it seemed good to the Holy Ghost and to us to lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things, that ye abstain from meats offered to idols, and from blood, things strangled, and from fornication, from which if ye keep yourselves, ye shall do well. Fare ye well. So they summed up those points, and there's a lot of good points in there. Christians shouldn't be living sexually immoral lives. We should be wanting to live pure lives and things like that. May the Lord bless you today. We're going to end there for today. Probably went a little longer than normal, but hopefully we're learning.